At this point, we have done the verification part of verification and validation. We have checked that we have input the right mathematical model into the tool and that it's given us a numerical solution where the numerical errors are acceptable. Let's turn our attention to validation, where we are looking at whether that model that we have solved reasonably well is an accurate enough representation of the physical problem. And if I go to my slide here, there are two ways one could do this for this particular case. The first is to compare the simulation results with measurements from the current experiment that students at Cornell do in the lab course. And I'll show you some results from that. One could also do comparisons with correlations from classical experiments. This is a very well-studied problem. And there are correlations, you know, for the friction factor and the Nusselt number versus Reynolds number and also the Prandtl number. I'll show you my results from comparisons to the current experiment. So that shows the temperature variation along the pipe axis. So if this were a cross section through the pipe, so this is a wall, and that's my axis. That's looking at temperature variation along the axis. Now this has to match between the experiment and simulation because we're taking that value in the simulation from the experiment because that's equal to the value at the inlet. So that's a check on the boundary condition. And then this one, so at the outlet where the flow is well mixed, you know, you get a good comparison between the experimentally measured value and the simulated value. This means that if you put the same amount of energy into the simulation, you're getting the same amount of temperature rise. So that's a check on the energy conservation. This plot shows the temperature variation along the wall. So that's this black line here from the simulation and then the corresponding measurements. There are, you know, probes along the wall here in the heated section. And again, you can see it captures that, you know, reasonably well. The green circles are the experiment. And then this is the variation of the mixed mean temperature in the heated section, and that's increasing linearly as it should when you have constant heat flux. So that's again a check on energy conservation. And in fact, one can take this plot and add it to this. Okay, so you could add that plot, which will look something like that, and that would be a good practice. I didn't get to do that. So that's what I would recommend that you include when you're reporting these results. And then one can also look at the pressure variation along the axis. So this is looking at the pressure. This has to match because we are taking the pressure over here that's measured and using that, or the pressure over here, and using that as a boundary condition. So again, that's a check on the boundary condition. But these, you know, these three, we have the additional three measured values of the pressure, and that matches quite well with the simulation. The simulation underpredicts the pressure drop, but that might be related to the turbulence model. So those are, you know, the kinds of validation checks that one can do and you know, conclude that our mathematical model that includes the conservation equations and the turbulence model, the KF non-turbulence model, is a reasonably accurate representation of the physical problem.